my last video when I talked about the single skill you need to learn as a programmer, being able to solve problems. I received a comment on that video that stated something very, very peculiar. I read, it says, well said, glad someone's making such videos instead of 10 programming languages you absolutely must learn in 2023. Yeah, this comment is actually very, 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 very me, because when I started learning programming, I often was distracted really by videos like these 10 skills you must learn in 2021 or in 2018. It's so insane the number of videos that follow those format that were being pumped out on a weekly basis. What I want to say is that most of this video, no matter how well intentioned they may be, it's quite distracting. Now, this is one of the reasons why it's so, because when you meet people, they first go to YouTube and check, okay, what is the skill I want to learn? Oh, I want to become a web developer, I want to be this, I want to be that, therefore what do I need to learn? And they go to YouTube and you see videos such as 20 languages you must learn in 2023, and their journey becomes so radical and spontaneous. Today you're learning HTML, you see another video, you're jumping from that, you're learning Python, you see another video, something else catches your attention, you're learning C++, something else catches your attention, you are learning CSS, or whatsoever these things may be. I want to say that is not the right way to actually go through learning programming in 2023 or whensoever. If you want to learn programming, you need to follow a quite tailored route and be less distracted by things you might actually be distracted by, such as 10 skills you must learn in 2023. And most times this video are never really realistic. I do understand that these videos are made so that people can probably know the trendy skill or the trendy language in that year, but I want to tell you today that I don't care about that, and you shouldn't really care about that. All you should be caring about right now is learning the tools that you need to build what you actually want to build. For example, you want to be a web developer. Of course, you need to learn JavaScript. You need to build on JavaScript. You need to learn HTML. You need to learn CSS. These are the skills you will end up learning. But even in the roots of becoming a web developer, it's easy to get distracted. And because the landscape is so crowded with technologies, for a moment, stop thinking about the technologies. Stop thinking about the frameworks. And for once, just sit down, relax, and ask yourself, what exactly do I want to build? What exactly do I see myself doing? What exactly should I actually be concentrating on? If you can get that sorted out, you will be less distracted by these videos or the new tech that pops up every now and then. And if you're able to do that, really, there will be less distraction for you. And that is really, really good for your programming or software development journey, because the less distraction you have, the more focused you will be. And the less distracted you have, the more products you will build. And so I want you to put it in the back of your mind in 2023. Don't go watching videos that say, oh, these are the 10 best skills you must learn in 2023. No, don't. I want to advise you, don't, because for beginners, these can be so distracting. They can even end up making sure that you do not really learn what you want to learn, because today you're learning this, tomorrow you're learning this, next tomorrow you're learning this. You're trying to follow the train, which you shouldn't be doing. You're trying to jump from one train to the other or follow the trend, what's popping right now. Those are not the things that you should concern yourself about. All you need to concern yourself about is to learn something and learn it well. And once you're done learning that something well, you will definitely know what next to do. So my advice for you in 2023, I repeat and I re-echo, don't get distracted. Build out a path you want to follow and follow it heads on. When you're done with that path, you will know where else you should turn your attention to. And remember, do not spend your time watching YouTube videos. Do not spend your time watching tutorials. Do not spend your time actually following through courses that you don't end up programming on your own. If you must watch YouTube videos, make sure the YouTube tutorials you are watching, you are going step by step and doing exactly what is being taught, and you're checking documentation, you are looking through other sources to verify things. That is the best way to learn programming, and that is the best way to become a software developer or to be a builder of code. That is the best way. You can watch a million hours of YouTube. That doesn't make you a programmer. You can watch a million hours of Udemy courses, and if you do not actually build things, you're wasting your time. You will think you're actually learning, but really, you're not learning at all. And that is a trap you should not really fall into. Learn and build. Implement whatsoever you learn and build. That's the best way to survive, and that is the best way to get less distracted in the area ever, ever changing world of tech. Having said this, I hope this video was useful to you and you find it inspiring for you to actually get things done and get less distracted. I've repeated distraction a whole lot of times, and that's because that is the trap most people fall into. Don't fall into the trap of being distracted. So thank you very much for watching this video. Subscribe to the channel if you are not already subscribed. Like this video if you actually found it useful, and follow me for more. And that will be all for now. Peace. I'm out.